My PhD is focused on marine debris, and in general, I focus on microdebris. I'm Jenny Brandon. I'm a PhD student in biological oceanography at Scripps Institution of Oceanography. This is a much easier and kind of more practical problem to see when you live right on the beach, like here. When you live in the kind of the middle of the country, it's not quite as obvious, but all of your wastewater, all of your rivers do eventually lead to the ocean, and all of your plastic consumption habits are eventually impacting the oceans that matter to all of us. So we just published a study comparing microplastic that we pulled out of the ocean that were naturally weathered and microplastics that we'd experimentally weathered here at Scripps. Microplastic are small plastic, and they're defined as smaller than 5 millimeters. The biggest ones are kind of the size of confetti. You can see them down to really small particles you can really only see under a microscope. In my opinion, the small plastics are the biggest problem because they can interact with the food chain in the most ways. So in my study, I looked at how the chemical bonds of the plastic were actually changing with aging. And so we did that by experimentally aging microplastics. We looked at seawater in sunlight, which kind of mimics ocean conditions, seawater in darkness, which mimics the bottom of the ocean, and then sunlight, which mimics beach conditions. And looking at that, then we looked at how those plastics, how their chemical bonds actually changed with weathering, and then we compared that to the oceanic plastics to see how their chemical bonds had changed with weathering, to see if we could kind of tell how old the plastic was. The ones we pulled out of the ocean were from the California Current and the North Pacific Subtropical Gyre, which is where the Great Pacific Garbage Patch is. And those ones, when you pull them out of the ocean, you really have no idea how long they've been there, what they used to be, where they came from. And so we were trying to figure out one piece of that puzzle, if we could tell how old they were. When you're going through the Great Pacific Garbage Patch, you really don't see a patch or an island. What you really see is a lot of blue water, and then you see a few really large items floating by. And as you stop the boat to look at those larger items or to pick them up, and you let the water really settle and the wake settle, that's when you start to see all the microplastic. And you just see these tiny kind of confetti-like pieces kind of come up out of the wake, and you just see that the water is full of them, just littered with these bright colored pieces. But as you're sailing through really fast, you don't see all of that, you just see blue water. So the first time you sail through it and you've maybe heard of this garbage patch or this garbage island, you're kind of shocked that it's not like that, that it's really blue. But then the longer you look, the more trash you see.